And Shelby, this year has been a blow to the labor movement in Wisconsin. The controversial collective bargaining law greatly weakens public sector unions, and in the end, it will likely lead to some of them disbanding.
As they have for years, volunteers spend the day before Labor Day setting up the Summerfest grounds for LaborFest. The event has featured big-name supporters, including a visit last year from President Obama. But in the wake of the collective bargaining fight that captured the state's attention for months, this year's event may be the most significant in decades for the labor movement.
If nothing else, I think we have a movement under our feet, which is something that we've needed for a long time.
Sheila Cochran, head of the Milwaukee Area Labor Council, thinks this year's event could draw new, younger people interested in unions and those who sat by in years past.
The untold story, I think, that's come out of the whole process is we woke up a lot of our labor members that were probably asleep at the switch, just taking things for granted, and now they know better.
UWM professor Mordecai Lee agrees that the collective bargaining law sparked an outcry of support for unions across the state. But he says, despite that passion, the new law likely means a number of unions will fail to reach the high standard for recertification and will disband.
It's almost like the labor movement a year from now will be exclusively in the private sector, and it'll almost disappear in the public sector. I think what happens over the next 90 days, if they decide to go ahead with a recall of Governor Walker, is really going to tell us if they think they've got one more big fight in them.
No group up to this point has said if they plan to try and organize that recall effort against the governor. Recently, Governor Walker has talked about working in a more bipartisan effort on that front. I reached out to his office and asked if the governor planned to attend any Labor Day events across the state tomorrow, but was simply told no comment. Reporting live outside Summerfest grounds, Brendan Conway, WISN 12 News.